If the patient is having rapid heart rate, so there is a good option to be able to fix it. Majority, almost all of these arrhythmias, we would be able to do catheter ablation. We go through the groin. Through the groin, there are two big veins, which are femoral veins. There are like about 1 or 2 inches each one of them. So we put the catheters through the groin, and these catheters go through the inferior vena cava. These catheters that I have, they have some electrodes, some platinums on it. This platinum, when it comes in contact with the heart, I would be able to see some mapping of the heart and activation of that area. It is as if, imagine that there is a metal here in the room and I have a metal detector. So I get the metal detector, I go do, 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 do. So I see where it is coming from because this which shows me on the mapping system, and I would be able to go and dig the metal with what? With the catheter ablation. I go and burn that area or freeze that area. So that is what we do during the catheter ablation. Either we freeze it or we burn it. So like if there is AVNRT, majority of the time I freeze it, but you can burn it as well. Or if it is some area inside the ventricle, there is one area of the spike, so it is coming and it is causing some extra beats and stuff. It is kind of like a cat and mouse game. I have to find where the mouse is and get it. The majority of time they are outpatient procedure. Rarely if we do like 3 or 4 procedure a day and we finish the last procedure at 4 p.m., I would prefer to not to send the patient home at 8 p.m. So we keep the patient overnight, but majority of the rest of the patient, they go home the same day.